A snarl of vines snakes upward from the corpse. After a moment, you realize the gruesome truth. They're not entangling the corpse, but bursting from it. The vines bear unmistakable signs of old elven magic, the likes of which Sion's once used to make entire forests spring to life. The vines have split the corpse's chest with incredible force. Thin roots wriggle from limbs and nail beds, anchoring it to the ground. The vines encircle a rough depression, as if something held there was violently torn free. Before you even registered the cool flesh, the vines lash around your wrist and drag you close. They pulse, tightening mercilessly, and release you, withdrawing sluggishly, as if sated, for now. You curse as the knife lances into your thumb, deflected neatly off one of the rough-skinned spores you and Thews took from the prisoner. A wet pop behind you, Thews on his knees, his spore cracked and smoking in his hand. Thin sprouts push from beneath his eyelids, his nose, his mouth, his screams choked beneath a single vibrant thistle blooming from his throat. You move to help your friend, but stop short. It's the elf woman, crouching behind Thews with her chains broken. She spits a phrase, Khmer Doran. And you are choking, the spore boiling in your hand as gas blinds you. You feel something stir in your chest, then shift, then tear.
She's gone, Farah. Gone!
Care for those seeds, my friend.
Easy, eh?
I got that special shipment you was asking after.
Worse than war rations, these.
Good.
Change back.
I ain't fit for beasts.
Why hasn't Alexander risen yet?
Sibyl gently places a hand on the small of your back. Her mouth reaches your ear with a whisper.
Let me have a word with the gentleman, would you? I've a little clue to follow up on.
Take your coin, then.
Sibyl steps forward and asks Griff the cook about the lone wolves. A dead little birdie told her he's the man to talk to. A little back and forth ensues. Money crosses hands, and before you know it, Sibyl stands back beside you, all smiles.
Thank you. We should make good on our escape, you know. I have to see a man about a wolf in the Hollow Marshes. Did I disappoint you? Oh, but don't worry. I might just have to push the next fella a little further. Zalaskar's his name. A name for the taking, if it comes to that.
Griff glances from his blade to you and back again. He turns the card over and holds it up to the light, smirking.
Got your hands on my sparkler, did ya? Well, put it to good use. The louses I have at the card table could use a good shake-up.
We find sorcery so dangerous. What in his death? When another divine arises, will source change?
I don't think I ain't watching. That's your fifth blue jester this round.
Back for more, freshy fresh? Let me guess. You came across a bit of gold and want to turn it into a bit more. Pleasure, Chief. Deal 'em up, Topsy.
Bottletop deals a hand, and each player glances at their cards. You have a lolly and two great hands. Not bad. Slug lays down two pink birds and a grimly. Bottletop folds. Ralvo sets down a set of four purple monarchs. That's one more than normally come in a deck. He's a dirty cheat. Again. Ralvo's eyes linger on the table, where the card lies as innocent as a piece of cardboard can be. His gaze travels up your torso to meet your eyes.
Now, where do you get a thing like that, mate?
Ralvo counts out the entirety of the table's pot without breaking eye contact.
Go!
Don't think I ain't watching. That's your fifth blue jester this round.
What of it?
Yeah, what of it?
Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you.
If you don't like the game, Topsy, you can fold.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy, cheating liars don't mean I can't beat you.
A little respect for Griff's right hand, Topsy girl.
Right hand, my winker. Fella's got more right hands than an octopus.
That's it. I call court. Pay up.
It's really uncanny, you know. You look just like that other sap. Though you lot all kind of look the same to me.
I don't think I ain't watching. That's your fifth blue jester this round.
What of it?
Yeah, what of it?
Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you.
If you don't like the game, Topsy, you can fold.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy, cheating liars don't mean I can't beat you.
A little respect for Griff's right hand, Topsy girl.
Right hand, my winker. Fella's got more right hand.
That's it. I call court. Pay up.
I'm not mad, darling. I'm not mad. Sweetheart?
Farah. She ain't coming back.
The woman looks up as you approach, wiping her brow with...
What do you need? By all means, get an eyeful.
Thank you.
Here's the oil. It's bolted on there tight, ain't it? Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this? Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this? Bless you, maniac. in their right mind would think of a thing like this? Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this? Where's the oil?
Rubbish. This again?
The woman looks up as you approach. Why?
What do you need? By all means, get an eyeful.
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much. Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat...
Griff glances from his blade.
You already know the terms. Nothing else to say. Sure, have a look.
If a magister finds this on you, you forget my name, here.
Give it down, will you?
Worse than war rations, these.
I got that special shipment you was asking after.
Give it down, will you?
Find source so dangerous. What is death constant? So void woken are attracted to source. But why? When a another divine arises, will source change back?
Ain't fit for beasts.
Why hasn't Alexander risen yet?
I've got that special shipment he was asking after.
Got it.
Worse than war rations, these.
Take your coin, then.
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much.
No, not like this. I won't let them.
Thank you. ready. Feeding.
Yet so quickly, we find sources so dangerous. What in his death caused him? So the void workers are attractive. But why? When an underlying price will force change back. Thank you. When another divine arises, will source change back? What is the kind of source? Yet so quickly, we find source so dangerous. What in his death caused? So void woken are attracted to source. But why? When another divine arises, will source change back? What if there are no sources? Why hasn't Alexander? When another divine arises, will source change back? What if there are no sources? Yet so quickly, we find source so dangerous. What in his death caused it? So the void woken are attracted to source. But why? When another divine arises, will source change back? What if there are no sources?
Junk.
You eat Griff's hand, and you see him putting animals, dead for days in the blistering sun, whole into his cooking pot. Probably best to pass on the stew.
Yet so quickly, we find source so dangerous. What in his death caused it? So Voidwoken are attracted to source, but why? When another divine arises, will source change back? What if there are no sorcerers left? Why hasn't Alexander risen yet?